Hey, good morning, everybody. Sports Live in the ATL here. Slid up on this Thursday. Counting down to the staycation, folks. Three more work days. Three more freaking work days. I don't know exactly what I'm going to do on the vacation slash staycation, but I figure go to the park. It's a very comfortable park. They got a nice walking trail. Go to Stone Mountain. Go out. Work out a lot. Entertain you guys a lot. And just do whatever the heck I want to do. I put myself in that situation in my life because of my choices that I can do whatever I want to do. And I will continue to do online and offline whatever I want to do. I will continue to say online and offline whatever I want to do. Like, comment, subscribe, click that notification bell. Care to support the channel. And you guys have been doing a fantastic job. If you want a video, shout for me personally, Cash App. $Hiving, and leave a message. I've enjoyed these Cash App messages. Everyone has been support to this point. I got one yesterday. I'm not going to mention who it was. I'm going to shout out that person, but if you care to, hey, show some love. I'm very appreciative with how the channel's going now. Very. Now, what I want to do in this video is, let's just go back. What if the Atlanta Falcons never went after Deshaun Watson? Now, I have mentioned this before, but I was more angry and laughing. But what if the Atlanta Falcons never sold out Matt Ryan trying to go after Deshaun Watson? Well, first of all, if Arthur Blank and Arthur Smith didn't try to, you know, go after Deshaun Watson, Matt Ryan would have been here. Matt Ryan would have been playing here. Plus, he could have tutored Desmond Ridder. Maybe we don't even draft Desmond Ridder. Who knows? I mean, the one thing about people that I just don't understand is that they think because one thing happens, that if they went back and did some things, that thing still would have happened. We have no clue if you would have gone after Desmond Ridder, if Matt Ryan would have still been here. People can say that, and people say that I'm in love with Matt Ryan. I like Matt Ryan. I respect what he did. He should have been a Super Bowl champion. He's a damn good quarterback. And look at it this way, folks. I bet you Matt Ryan could make those simple plays that Desmond Ridder and Marcus Mariota couldn't. You wouldn't see Matt Ryan throwing an interception on his butt. I mean, I have seen Matt Ryan throw some bad passes in my time. And a lot of that was against teams that were very pressing up front. Baltimore, Tampa Bay, to be exact. Arizona, in Arizona. But when Matt Ryan played pretty bad teams, he usually ate them up. Washington on Sunday, I am not going to guarantee it, but I would bank that Matt Ryan would not have thrown three interceptions. And in those two possessions in the red zone, we would have got points out of it. I'm not necessarily saying touchdowns on both, but we probably would have got at least one touchdown and a field goal and could have changed that whole complexion. And I don't think Matt Ryan throws an interception at the 50. But what if the Falcons never went after Deshaun Watson? Well, Matt Ryan would have been our starting quarterback. We never would have got that joke Marcus Mariota. Might not have even drafted Desmond Ridder. And let's just say if Matt Ryan was here and we still drafted Desmond Ridder, Matt Ryan would have played, would have tutored him, and I guarantee, if Arthur Smith decided to say, hey, Matt, we want you here, but we want to try to implement Desmond Ridder, what do you think? Matt Ryan would have, I'm pretty sure, would have sat on the bench as a backup, let Desmond Ridder play and tutor this man. And we wouldn't be seeing all these stupid games by him and all these bad plays. And if he did, it probably wouldn't have happened again. But no, what did the Falcons do? They disrespected Ryan, went after a guy who sold us out, and hasn't really done much since he sold us out. Since Deshaun Watson left Houston, he really hasn't done anything. So the Falcons dodged a bullet there. So you know what you did? You lost twice. You lost because Deshaun Watson is injury prone and he hasn't really done shit. And you lost your franchise quarterback. And then you had to dibble dabble with Marcus Mariota, Tyler Heinicke, and Desmond Ridder. And now you're talking about Justin Fields, and I hear rumors about Daniel Jones out there through the NFL trade rumors, because the deadline is October 31st. The Falcons screwed themselves while going after Deshaun Watson. That's facts. You don't disrespect a legend who gave everything for this organization, whether you like him or not, and not expect backlash. Remember how I've always said, everything goes in your life based on the choices you make? Well, the Falcons made a terrible choice trying to go after Deshaun Watson in the Flash, and look what's happened since. You know, the Falcons got what they deserve. Karma, Arthur Smith, Arthur Blank got what they deserve. And a lot of these dumbass, you know, Deshaun Watson fans, Matt Ryan haters, who now, ironically, love Matt Ryan, y'all all are getting what y'all deserve. I'm not getting what I deserve because I never crapped on Matt Ryan. So I'm not getting what I deserve. I deserve to see this team win. I deserve this team to play, have good quarterback play week in and week out. At least every other, you know, at least out of the first, six games, at least five games of good quarterback play. We have had one solid quarterback play from Ritter. Everything else has been either terrible or mediocre or below. So I'm suffering because of it, because of the stupid decision to go after Deshaun Watson. You know, so it is what it is with that. But imagine, just imagine what it would have been like if we didn't sell out Matt Ryan and try to go after that bum ass Deshaun Watson. So now we don't even know what our quarterback's going to be the rest of the year because, you know, you know Ritter's on thin ice. We don't know what, now they're talking about drafting a quarterback next year. Jesus fucking Christ, man. Like, comment, subscribe, notification bell, support the channel. Want a video shout out? Cash App $HYBING, and I'll do it on Friday or Saturday. Stupid decisions, you get stupid results. And I'll see you in the next one.